We're planting rhodes grass to cut and bale for hay. Probably in another 8 weeks we should be able to cut a bit of hay off here.
Just packing Anthony's stuff. He's heading off for a couple of days to go and pick up some of our equipment that will help us with harvesting. Hopefully he'll bring me back a present.
After he's finished seeding, Anthony's off to pick up $500,000 worth of new machinery from his local supplier.
Anthony's taking my truck. I think he's real impressed about it, hey? The nice pink truck for a manly man.
We've got two trucks here. Danielle and myself both got a licence. It's a bit hot at the moment and my aircon's not working, so I'm going to take Danielle's truck. I think I might wear a mask or something because of the colour of the frigging thing. I'll just pull up at night where no one can see me and do what I've got to do, get in and out.
While the new 30-hectare field has only just been planted, in just 8 weeks, it should look like this. The crops under the other two 30-hectare pivots are almost ready for harvest. In the next month, they need to be cut, dried and baled with the equipment Anthony's heading off to collect.
This is like pretty much an oasis in the middle of a desert. The grass is nearly to your chest. Anthony expects to be mowing the grass for bales every 4 to 6 weeks. And that's something that we will be getting in Ireland.
Anthony hopes each pivot will generate $400,000 in annual hay sales. But the freshly seeded third pivot field will need a lot of TLC before it can start bringing in any money.
You want water, like in your first 2 inches, like when you planted like this, because it's only a little fine seed, like a carrot seed. And it's only just under the surface, so you want to keep the top of it moist so the seed can germinate. If you miss it for a couple of days, the grass goes dead.
It's a lot of weight and put it on us because we've got to make sure it gets done. Because obviously if it doesn't, Anthony won't be happy. When he gets back, getting hooked in to cut hay and bale everything up so then we can start making money.
We're running water out here, which will cover about 20 hectares. Trench a line through here, straight down there to the junction, then head north. I've got a bit of a map here for you anyway. Out there, that's the existing pipeline.
The farm's only source of water flows through a network of 20 kilometres of pipelines crisscrossing the property. Water is pumped from boreholes drilled 50 metres down to a natural reservoir known as an aquifer. Part of Anthony's grand plan is to extend the pipeline and open up a new paddock.
A couple of days, we should be able to get some water.
Yeah, be awesome.
Shane's an Irishman.
Yeah, so we can do that. We can do that between 2:15, length 15.
Yeah, can you tell? A pretty strong accent.
I could use the pun on the hatch.
Pun on the back of this.
Pretty hard to understand on the two-way. We'll go for a run down the line where we're going to put it. We're pretty happy with him, so I think it'll all work out. He's going to have fun for the next 3 days, eh?
You're like, happy days, I'm going. My role is here to look after the farm, so do anything and everything that the farm may need. So it'll be my first time running the farm myself. I want to do a good job, like, you know, well, this is their livelihood. So it is. Well, if it doesn't go right, like, you know, they will suffer.
Hey, come and say goodbye to Dad.
Where are you going, Daddy?
Dad, you want to come? You do. Dad's got to go and get some stuff so we can make hay for Bella.
Bye-bye! Bye-bye!
We are drenching here to lay a new water pipe so we can open up a new paddock of 20 hectares so we can grow some more grass for hay. And these are the teeth of the trenchers. It's basically like a chainsaw, except it digs into the ground, so it'll cut through just about anything. That'll just tear through a pipe if it hits it.
The goal for me is just to dig the rest of the dirt out that the trencher has missed, so it's nice and level. And if it's on like a sharp point, it could damage the pipe while we're laying it. Black star figure just there. That's where it ends. There we got about 15, 20 metres left. We'll have the trenching done before Anthony gets home, like, unless something badly goes wrong.
Woo-hoo!
Trench is finished. There. Done.
No more digging. Yes. For now.
For now.
Yeah, it's good to finish this section of trenching. We got about 100 metres left to go to the bore, and then we can start laying the pipe out and then start pumping water.
Elijah, you got a copy? You've got no freaking water.
So we started trenching and we've hit this pipe line.
How bad?
Busted the hole in the pipe.
Righto, I'll be there in a minute.
I don't know where we're going, because I don't know where the boys are.
They've hit one of the main pipes that sends water to, like, the pivots and that, so not good. Pivots are stopped now. Now the crop's not getting watered. Got no water going to any of our tanks. Nobody's right without water. Water's like liquid gold to everybody, especially us. I think they're up here.
Where's my son?
I want to take a photo of this.
Shake, knee deep, like not even knee deep, hip deep in a finale. Yes!
Desperate to finish trenching before Anthony returns, Shane's been caught with his pants down.
What happened?
This pipe isn't on the map, so we didn't know it was here. And we had it.
Are you going to be able to fix it?
Well, if we had a clamp. The clamp over, we could have fixed it here and then.
Is there nothing in that shed?
Nah, we don't have one.
Like, if we weren't able to seal the pipe and fix it, hey, we would have just wallered and died, and we'd pretty much have to start from scratch again.
Yeah, this is a huge issue.
We can't not water.
I could probably make up a clamp.
Well, at least if you can do something to repair it, then we can turn the pivots back on. But it should drain out of here if he's...
Can you get out? Literally can't get out. Oh, this is gold.
Now we're just going to do a bit of a dodgy fix on it, pass us some time so we can keep water pumping.
And these are the teeth of the trencher, it's caught onto it. Put a nice gouge on it. Clean the surface. We'll put another piece of pipe over it and glue it into position and a few straps around it to hold in place. So that should be a good enough fix to keep us pumping until we get the proper parts.
Cutting this there.
Straps. Well, they're going to be the clamping force to hold it all together while the glue dries. And it should seal up the pipe long enough for us to get the new parts in and get it fixed properly. Right. Hopefully nothing happens, nothing leaks, and that'll be ideal. And we can get everything back watering again. Elijah's gone back around to turn all the water pumps on again. And it all has to fall up before we get any pressure. And until that happens, we won't know if this patch is actually fixed. This patch has worked. Sent the pivots on, rotating.
And nothing broke yet. Touch wood.
So we can start trenching here again.
Just don't start trenching, let's start trenching over there.
Look, who's back? Dad's back! Say hello, Daddy!
Hi, see you, Annie. Is that good cattle?
Yeah.
Good cattle?
Oh, big cuddles.
There's always a bit of a surprise when someone leaves, but we understand they've got to do what's best for their family. Shane done a great job patching his pipe up here. We've got the new fittings in. Now we'll fix him up properly.
Oh my God, Dad.
What?
There's no water down there.
Where'd the water go?
And we're done.